Problems, problems, problems. Are you tired of having problems? Well, let's talk about where those problems are really coming from and how you can quickly solve them. All right, welcome back to the channel. I am Neil Winteregg with Matterhorn Business Development. And today I want to talk about something that isn't just business related, but a little bit of a life philosophical relationship that you may or may not have noticed going on in your life. And that subject is you receive from other people what you put out to other people or what you put out into your life and into your livingness. An obvious example of that is somebody who's always pissed off and looking for a fight always seems to find somebody to fight with. Even if it's nothing that should be fought over, they will find something to argue and fight about, even the smallest thing. And that is because that person walks around angry, looking to fight, looking to pick a fight, looking for somebody to set them off. And all you have to do is bump into them the wrong way and say, oh, excuse me. And then that sets them off, right? Those are obvious examples. But let's look at some other examples that might go along with this as well. Problems. Have you ever noticed that some people are just always getting stuck in these small, minor details and problems? And it's almost like when you would be doing that same job, you might have one problem. But when this person does that job, there's 15 or 20 problems, and there's problems that you've never even heard of before, because that type of person is always looking for a problem and always has to have a problem to be happy. That's honestly the way it works. They have to be pissed off to be happy. They have to have problems to be happy. And they go around creating more and more problems for people. And it's very unique because they can't see a simple solution to something. They have a simple problem and they have 20 steps to resolve that problem. And I come along and I go, well, why don't you just do that? And they go, oh, that would never work. They've already decided that the problem is a very complicated, long, drawn out problem that's going to take weeks to resolve, when you could probably fix it in 5 minutes, or it's not even a problem to begin with, and it doesn't even need any attention put on it. But that is what happens when you put out a vibe. You put out some sort of a wavelength, let's say, and you walk around and you say, I'm pissed off all the time and I dare you to talk to me about it. And guess what? You're gonna find somebody who's willing to call you out on that or mention that, that sets you off, right? That is what you are going around and putting out there. And what's funny is when you have a bad customer in your business and they go, oh, I'm gonna tell all my friends not to do business with you. We'll call him Joe the Jerk. Joe the Jerk is all pissed off. He leaves your business and you get scared because Joe the Jerk is gonna go tell all these people how bad you are. And you go, yeah, I know you're friends with Joe the Jerk, and you know he came in, and they go, oh yeah, of course, Joe would always do that. We know that about Joe. Everybody knows that about Joe, except for Joe. Joe's the only person who doesn't realize that he's the jerk. Everybody else knows that, but he's putting that out there and you put that out there as well. So the flip side to this is, if it's not a problem, it doesn't become a problem. If you want to grow and you want to succeed, you'll find a way to grow and you'll find a way to succeed. These are the obvious differences. And we see it in a lot of different types of situations in sports teams. And you know, they lose a couple of games and they go, we're gonna come back and we're gonna finish strong. And that team comes back and wins 20 games in a row and they become the champions. Whereas another team, you know, they lose a couple of games and the world is over, we're done for, there's no way we can recover from this. And sure enough, they lose a game that they should never have lost to begin with because they already agreed, oh, we're just done for. It happens in life. It happens in your business. So when you're looking at your business, look at, what can I solve? What problems can I do to do better? How can I make changes that are going to make us do better and be better? If you look at it from that perspective, all of a sudden, problems start to fall away from you. But if you go, oh my gosh, look at all these problems. Oh my gosh, I forgot about all these problems. Oh, now we don't have enough money to pay the electric bill. And everything just gets worse and worse and worse because that's the way you go around looking at it. So when you start to realize that there's barriers, stop looking at them as barriers and start looking at it as a, how do we fix this? How do we solve this? What can we do to become more in control over this? How am I going to take that problem and have it no longer be a problem? What can I do that makes this less of a problem? And if you start to come up with like a list of things that you have to solve in your life, you'll start to realize that there's simple solutions to them if you just sit down and solve them one at a time rather than looking at all 15 things that are going wrong. Find a problem, fix it, and move on to the next problem with the idea that you are going to be able to fix it, and things start to loosen up and things start to get better for you. So I really do hope that this helped you. Please hit that thumbs up, subscribe, comment down below. I'd love to hear from you, and we'll see you next time.